farmer, was there something in your experience that prepared you for being a congresswoman?
Well, you got to be persistent. You have to be comfortable dealing with the public, and I've always had a farm stand, or today I actually own a restaurant and an inn as well as the farm, so I'm very comfortable dealing with the public or people's complaints or the issues. You know, you kind of get a thick skin, and you're not uncomfortable working hard. I mean, farming takes a lot of work, and you got to be used to doing that, and I think all those things prepared me very well. And I think in particular, when I first ran for the legislature, I had a very Republican district, and I'm a Democrat. But I was able to bridge that gap with people, whether I met them in the grocery store or at their door or at a forum, because I'm used to running a small business, and I know what the issues are around farming. And so I didn't come with any particular ideology, but more of a common sense kind of idea of how do you get these things done, and how do we, you know, sort of share in these issues together. And I will say, food and agriculture and the food that we put on our table is an issue that bridges the gap. It's not Republican or Democratic. You know, people want healthy food. They want it at all economic levels and certainly at all ages. So it's a great issue to work on.
Now, we care at Livestrong not only about the consumers, but also about the farmers and the farm workers. What would you say to people who say that organic farming is an elitist concern?
Well, you know, you hear that sometimes, but, you know, for a whole variety of reasons, I don't think that makes any sense. The truth is today that the majority of parents who choose to buy baby food go with organic. And they do so because a parent of any economic level is worried from the start about what they're going to put in their kid. And whether it's buying organic milk or organic baby food, you can see it across the board. And that's true whether you're shopping at Whole Foods or if you're shopping at Walmart. Walmart is attempting to be the largest retailer of organic foods in the country right now. And they wouldn't be going after that market if they didn't think that everyone at every income level wanted to eat more organic food. So I'm pretty convinced from the people I talk to that wherever you are economically, wherever you are politically, people want to buy more locally grown produce. They love the idea that they would know who the farmer was or they could know where it came from. And people truly do want to put better food into their kids' and their families' diets. A lot of times it's an issue of affordability. And so that's one of the reasons we've supported a lot of programs, both to make it easier for SNAP recipients to buy healthy foods, but also to help farmers transition, to make the transition into organic, to make their products more affordable. I have a bill right now to support more organic research, because as this interest has gone up in organic food, our supply has declined in this country, and we're actually importing a lot more corn and wheat and things organically grown than we ever have before because we can't get them here. So one of the things we're saying is if there was more research, if there was more support for farmers, it would be a great benefit to our farmers because they don't have to work with those unhealthy chemicals. They get a better price for their product. They're doing a better thing for their land, something that they may want to pass on to the next generation. It holds the topsoil. So there's a lot of reasons to do it. And to call it elitist, may have been true 40 years ago when only a few people knew about it. But it's a $50 billion industry today, and that is because consumers at all level are saying, give me that healthy food.
Well, can you tell me, do you have concerns about the Environmental Protection Agency? Are they protecting the environment and consumers, and why or why not?
I have a lot of concerns about the Environmental Protection Agency, about some of the rulings that the USDA has made. I mean, one of my jobs I see here in Washington is to be a watchdog, to fight back, whether it's issues around rulings that they make on chemicals that I think should have more testing, things like some of the rules that have come before the USDA where they should be more directive about making sure that a free-range chicken is actually out on the range, pecking in the grass, picking up, healthy nutrients and bugs and things like that, as opposed to, sort of like pretending and not really following the rules. So we follow all those things very closely, and I serve on two committees, one that has oversight of the EPA and one of the USDA. So you can follow us anytime, and we are regularly going after them, whether it's about chemicals like Roundup, which we see too much of today, or some of the rules that govern how we technically administer the organic farming regulations and making sure that they're strict and they're that everyone follows the right rules.
why is it important for people out there and voters to care about politics right now, and what should they be doing?
Well, I have to say, I've never seen the voter more engaged than they are right now, which is wonderful, because we have a lot of challenges in front of us right now. Consumers and citizens make a huge difference. One is how they vote with their pocketbook. You know, if you're buying food from the local farm down the road, you're joining a CSA, you're showing that farmer that you care about what they do. Sometimes you're willing to pay a little extra to make sure that they can stay in business. And you're looking them right in the eye and saying, I want you to tell me how this was grown. So there's no question about the label. It's the question of, like, have you talked to that person? But also, keeping in contact with state legislators and members of Congress is really important, because people, they count the emails they get, the phone calls. And if all we ever hear from is the very well-financed lobby. In fact, there are more lobbyists on the Hill and more money spent on food, food processing, and agriculture than there is in the defense industry, and people don't often understand that. So we need to hear all your voices on whatever concerns you, and you should let people know all the time. Particularly now, we're in the lead up to the Farm Bill. That only happens every 5 years. It's important policy. But consumers' voice, citizens' voice makes a huge difference.
Thank you so much for taking the time
today to talk
to us about this essential topic for consumers. It clearly is important, and the way that you've underscored the issues helps so much.
Well, thank you.